Well, this game had it all, regardless the outcome. We have the king of bitching it up playing good. I can't believe I said that shit on TikTok that one day that they're gonna Spurs are gonna come retire the king of bitching it up and the king of fucking it up's number under the number 7, you know, Fabricio Oberto. We had Jock Landale minutes. Young Devo got hurt. It was the Trae and Trae show. We had Jakob, who had a portal jam, like a hold me back Anna Grace Barlow cup type of moment. This game had it all and too much of all of it. Although sadly, young Devo ended up going down with a quadrap injury. So yeah, like I said, this was our last game before Thanksgiving. This was like our own personal, another edition 1000, it seems like. That seems like how many of, you know, having our own personal Chevrolet Monte Carlo 400 at Richmond. You know how in NASCAR you that race has been the last race before the chase for the cup began, 2017, because 2017 was the last time the Monte Carlo 400 was the last race before the chase. Well, this was like another one that was in there, where it's like our Monte Carlo 400 in the basketball universe, our last Spurs game before Thanksgiving. So, yeah, that was a fun game no matter the outcome. I mean, we suck, I get it, but, I mean, at least, I mean, this team cannot do shit for all 48 minutes. They'll do, like, for 12 minutes, they got a good first quarter, and then they had a good, like, beginning the middle of second quarter, but at the end of the second quarter, the Hawks turned it on like Tommy Rose, and that's when the Spurs fell apart, too. So, it's like, you know, we had a good first quarter, but at the same time, we can't do shit for all 48 minutes. So that basically sums up this year's team. We're 4-13. I knew we were going to be bad this year for what is my 25th anniversary as a Spurs fan, but I didn't know we were going to be this bad. Like, goddamn. I mean, there was something else I was trying to say too, and I'm trying to remember. Oh yeah, at least when in the end, when all said and done, a top 5 pick will be worth it. But knowing our history, we'll probably send his ass to the G League like we do with Primo this year. How we kept doing with Trae Jones last and La Vida Luca last year and the year before. You know, I mean, what more do you want me to say? I mean, same stupid bullshit every single night. I mean, I knew, like I said, I didn't know we were going to be this bad. I mean, I knew we were going to be bad in general, but I didn't know we were going to be bad. See, this is what us Spurs fans are not used to. Like, majority of other NBA teams who have gone through this, let alone sports teams in general, you know? You know, after so many years of winning and being spoiled rotten growing up, well, for me, since I was a child, I mean, we're going through growing pains as a team now that I'm almost 30. I'll be 30 in less than 2 years. I'll be 30 in 2024, and I'm not ready for that at all. Considering that, you know, I watched the Spurs win the championship in almost every single house I've lived in. I watched them win the 1999 championship, their first one in the house on West 122nd. I watched them win, well, I fell asleep for the 2003 one, but I saw the 2005-2007 championship in the Lenore House in Michigan. I could have seen them win 2013 and on Sandhurst had they finished the job in game 6. You know, even though they did win in 2014 and I still was in the Sandhurst house, I wasn't even at home at the time they won the championship in 14. I was in the hotel because me and my dad were in Michigan for NASCAR weekend, which the Sirius Satellite Radio 400 was the same day as Game 5. And unfortunately for me, I could not go crazy and do all this other, so, like, wild and crazy shit because we were in the hotel. Because then I tried to risk it, like, going all crazy in the hotel. We would have gotten thrown out for a noise complaint. So I had to keep it down. I had to keep it as quiet as possible. So, unfortunately, I wasn't able to celebrate the 2014 championship in the Sandhurst house because me and my dad were out of town for NASCAR weekend in Michigan. And ever since moving here, I've not seen them win a championship here yet. And let alone, I thought that when we signed Aldridge in 2016, I thought we were going to see it happen in this house that in the 2015-16 season. And since that didn't happen, I thought we were going to see it happen in this house at least 2016-17, the first year we didn't have Tim. You know, that was, we were still good our first year without Tim. It's going to be a while. Like, if, you know, if we, I mean, hopefully we'll go back to our winning ways, but then I'd say give it 2 to 3 years, at least to the maximum 4 years, you know, we'll be back to our winning ways again. But no matter how long it takes for us to be good again, you know, it's going to happen eventually, if not anytime soon. So, like I said, I'm not watching Friday's game against Boston because, you know, I found something better to do. I'm watching Nickelodeon instead for the Loud House Christmas movie. And I don't even watch the Loud House animated show. I'm not even a fan of that show. But I have a few friends, famous friends from past TV shows, you know. I have Lexi DiBenedetto from Night Squad. Marcus Fulmar from Drama Club, which, you know, we still haven't gotten word whether or not that's getting a season 2. I have them I want to, like, support over there, you know. And then, of course, you know, Monday, episode 10 of 11 of season 1 of The Big Leap. I'm not watching the Washington game because, you know, we're probably going to suck in that one, too. And, you know, I want to see what happens in The Big Leap, you know, to continue the story. And, you know, we still have to catch up on, you know, A Million Little Things, episode 7, I think it is. Episode 7. I can always double check. I can always double check. I know episode 8 of the Goldbergs we have to catch up on. I lost count. I'll have to go back and check. And so I'll probably acknowledge it in the Thanksgiving vlog tomorrow. But, you know, we still have to catch up on the last episode of the Goldbergs and A Million Little Things. And which, that's what we're going to do on Saturday, you know, after the haircut vlog, you know, with Cousin Kenny and my buddy Nick Nero. And, you know, we're probably going to miss that girl Lele tomorrow because, even if we're home in time after, you know, being with the Olivereses for Thanksgiving, we're probably going to be way too tired to watch it. So, and not only that, even if we weren't too tired, there's no way I can make work on the Thanksgiving vlog and do a That Girl Lele reaction video in one go. That would just be way too much. So, Saturday we'll do TV catch-up day. We'll catch up on Goldberg's and AMLT on the DVR. And on the Nickelodeon website, we'll catch up on That Girl Lele. So, I will see you all tomorrow for the Thanksgiving vlog. Have a good night tonight and a better day tomorrow. Take care, everyone. Good night. And also, Sunday will also be dinner at Fireball Man. So, even if I have to miss Las Leyendas del Templo on Sunday, so be it. I'll bring you a video of me having dinner at Fireball Man's and us having fun over there. I'll see you later, everyone.